9 universities from across Europe gathered at NATO's Undersea Research Center to pit their robotic submarines against each other in a competition that tests the team's ingenuity and intelligence. The subs need to navigate an underwater course and must do so completely autonomously.
This is an entire leap of faith. They are very reliant on the program that they've written that tells that machine that when it gets a certain input, this is what it has to do. And of course, they've got no way of communicating with it once it leaves the surface.
Most of the AUVs, or autonomous underwater vehicles, are driven around on the surface via Wi-Fi. Once underwater, many of the machines use sonar and cameras to steer clear of obstacles. The course set up at the Undersea Research Center in La Spezia, Italy, requires the subs to go through a set of gates, track a pipe, and then follow the edge of a wall. The judges use sonar to track the location of the subs while they're underwater. And in one of the qualifying rounds, one sub went astray and had to be rescued by a diver. The AUVs weren't big-budget projects by any means. The brains of some of them aren't much different than what some of you are using to watch this video.
Well, our approach of this AUV is to build a very cheap AUV that's easy to handle. As you can see, we have a waterproof case on it, and that's very different from the design of the other teams. So if we want to do anything on our hardware, we have just to open the case. And here in it, you see a small netbook or a notebook with a dual core. And so we're able to work on this AUV as much as we want to.
NATO created the contest to encourage students to seek careers in science and technology. The organization also sees it as a way to improve the technology we already have today, some of which is now deployed in the Gulf of Mexico.
Of recent interest, the Gulf oil spill, they've been using a huge amount of autonomous technology there because obviously it's very deep, and we can actually send unmanned robots in to do an awful lot of the filming and sensing of just how bad the problem is without putting human beings into harm's way.
Students weren't just judged on their subs' performance on the course, but on their websites, papers, videos, and presentations as well. In the end, the team from Spain's University of Girona won the contest. Reporting from Boston, I'm Nick Barber, IDG News Service.